Good afternoon, everyone. I request Amina to unmute herself. Let me quickly introduce her. So we have Ms. Amina Zarar today. And she is going to take one of the very interesting topics, that is virtual etiquette. And it is actually a need of the hour. Because we all are virtually connecting from last almost 1.5 months. And you know, watching people doing so many things which is not matching to the etiquette, and it is very much required now, because maybe post lockdown also there are so many clients you know, will ask for virtual sessions other than the classroom sessions, because it is very cost effective. As per my discussion with many HRs, the companies are thinking about it, and so this is going to help us. This session is definitely going to help us. So Amina is basically health and, you know, she is actually a corporate trainer. She is clinical nutritionist and a freelance trainer and lifestyle coach. She belongs to Bangalore, and she's doing so much for the community during this lockdown period, and, you know, providing her support to the community people on the regular basis. Maybe because of that, she is not here every day with us. But I'm sure today she is here with something different, and something which is very, very useful for all of us in this particular session. So I just request Amina to unmute and take over the session.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'll be starting the video in a minute, then you can see me. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Swati. That was a really nice introduction. It's been a very long time and I haven't been able to connect with everyone here. It's for various reasons. There's been a lot of community work, and apart from that, there's also been a few work engagements. And as much as I try to catch up with our meetings, whatever I miss, thereafter, Dr. Swati duly posts it on the group, and I'm trying my best. So I'm very glad to be here today. This is an opportunity for me to connect with a very awesome group, the Trainers Club, and very talented people on this group. And today, as we already know, that there is a coronavirus going around, and it is called COVID-19. This COVID-19 has brought into perspective some aspects of connectivity which was not really popular before, but now, some of the industries are unaffected, no doubt, but there are some who are quite affected, and connectivity on the internet brings a possibility of connections across various offices, brings about the possibility of connecting with the workforce wherever they are and keeping them engaged, connecting with your clients for whatever work you might have, to be able to plan ahead. And therefore, this is a very important virtual etiquette presentation that we are having today. Before I begin, I'd like to know and understand everyone here on this group. So if you can unmute yourself, just tell me your name and tell me what you're looking forward to in today's webinar. I'll be very happy.
I'm PR Choudhury.
So if I call out your name and if you unmute yourself, that'll be great. Can Parag unmute himself and please tell me what you're looking forward to?
Yeah. Hello.
Yes, I can hear you, Parag.
Yeah. Hi. Good afternoon. I was looking at, in terms of, since the topic is of virtual etiquette, in terms of how, as a presenter or a person who's engaging with the participants, can improve the level of engagement.
Absolutely.
I don't know if that
Thank
is in
you
the
for topic. Sharing a thought, Parag. Can I have Tarannum connect with me and tell me what you're looking forward to?
Hello, Amna ma'am. Actually, I'm very happy to see you. And first time I heard this word virtual. I know the etiquette, but first time I heard this word virtual. So I'm looking forward what is all about, and I just want to learn all about virtual etiquette.
Absolutely, absolutely. Great thoughts, Tarannum. Thank you for sharing that with us. Ashok, could you please unmute yourself, sir? Yeah, Mr. Ashok.
So, Amina, can we do one thing? We ask the people who want to speak. Is it okay? Instead of going to everyone, because like we have 20 or 29 people. So, are you okay to go to everyone?
I would like just one line from them, doc. I won't take too much of the time.
Okay, so can we use chat box, or that will consume so much of time, I believe, like if you go to everyone.
I'll try to keep it short, dog, but just kindly I request you to allow me, because
no problem.
I want to understand people's perspective before, because I need to connect with that perspective during the presentation.
Sure, no problem. If you can manage within the time,
I
don't mind. Yeah.
Thank you, dog. I'd like everyone to please cooperate and kindly unmute yourself and just give me one line on why you're here and what are you looking forward to today?
I'm P.R. Chaudhary. I'm P.R. Chaudhary.
Hello. Yes, Mr. Chaudhary, please go ahead.
In fact, this virtual part, I'm really interested to know. Etiquette part, I know it. But I look forward because I heard about you, that you are a very good trainer.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chaudhary. I hope this is a fulfilling presentation for you. The next person, Mr. Ashok, if you can hear me, could you unmute yourself and go ahead, please?
Yeah, I'm hearing you. Myself as a trainer, I'm also interested to know the virtual etiquettes.
Fantastic. Okay, Mr. Anil Jain, could you please do the same? Mr. Anil Jain? Could you please unmute yourself?
Yes.
Yeah, just share a line about your thoughts on why you're here and what do you hope to gain from today?
Just want to learn something new.
Something new about virtual etiquette.
Yes.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for joining in. Dattaram Valvankar, sir, could you please?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
I am
sir.
Etiquettes, but what is this virtual etiquette is all about? I would like to know it in detail so that I am not.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're most welcome, sir. I'd like to ask Mr. Rajat Shom next. Good afternoon. Could you share your thoughts why you're here today and what you're looking forward to, sir?
Good afternoon, Amina.
Good afternoon, sir. How are you? Please just give me one line, sir. I think I just need to know one line about why you're here and what you're hopefully going to gain today by being here. So, what are you looking forward to? Okay, I think we have lost the next person. Could Mr. Debojit unmute himself?
Good afternoon, Amina. How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
I'm doing fine, thank you so much. My primary objective of attending this workshop is that, along with other fellow trainers, we all are probably aware of the classroom etiquette or the training room etiquette. Yes. This is for the first time that we all are approaching the virtual world for delivery of training.
Absolutely.
So it makes a lot of sense to understand what are the etiquette required to manage the
Absolutely. Work. Thank you for sharing your thoughts, sir. So that was really nice. Could Mr. Deepak also unmute himself and share his thoughts, please?
Good afternoon, Amina.
Hi, good afternoon, Deepak. Tell me, sir.
I've been doing virtual training sessions and wanted to get the best practices or rather learn something new. I could take it up in my sessions. Thank you.
Sure. Thank you so much for sharing that with us, Mr. Deepak. Thank you so much. Okay, Imran, could you come in, unmute yourself and share your thoughts, please? I see you have unmuted, so you can begin.
Yeah, I think this is virtual communication, so how to.
Please speak into the mic, Imran. Sorry?
Hello.
Yes, I can hear you now.
Yeah, hi, good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon.
So this is the first time I heard this word virtual etiquette. So what I feel this is related to virtual communication, how to behave during the virtual communication, and I'll be happy to know more about this virtual etiquette. So thank you so much.
I'm glad you're here today. All right, Mr. Iqbal, could you please unmute yourself?
Good afternoon, ma'am. Iqbal here from Kerala. For me also, it's a new subject, so I am already doing some online trainings. So I just want to inculcate all these things to my training. Thank you.
I hope I can connect with you and help you to establish that. Priya, could you please unmute yourself, ma'am, and share your thoughts with us?
Hello, good afternoon, ma'am. This is Priya Tekwani and I'm from Maharashtra. Okay. First of all, let me congratulate you. Then this is one of my favorite styles of, you know, conducting pattern. So I like the way you started the session, and I guess it is about do's and don'ts for the participants as well as the presenter, because this concept is new in the online session that we are conducting at present. It's itself a new concept, so definitely virtual etiquettes would be new. So
I hope you are able to take home a new learning today about virtual etiquette. We are all feeling the same way, and some of us are here connected from a different city. I'm really glad you're connected here from Bombay, and it's really nice that you're here. Thank you so much, Priya, for sharing your thoughts. Irene, could you please unmute yourself and share your thoughts with us?
Hi, I've just joined in, so I don't know what trail to pick up right now. So I don't know what
are you looking forward to? Just tell us that.
Okay. This sounded to me like an interesting session, and something that I have not attended before. So I just want hopefully to get a lot of learning from this session.
So true for most of us. I think there's one person who's calling himself or herself iPhone. Could you unmute yourself? And also, I request you to rename yourself, please. It's better to have the first name. iPhone, could you please unmute yourself? Are you able to hear me, please? I request iPhone to unmute yourself. Are you here? Okay, I'm going to assume she's not here. Okay, Monali Thakur, I see your name.
Hi, Aminam. This is Monali here.
Hi, Monali.
First of all, great topic. I'm really looking forward, although I have just a few expectations, if I can tell you.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so basically, I also want, I'm sure you must have already made sure that you're going to cover everything related to virtual etiquette. But a specific thing which I would like you to mention is like how to use the video properly when one is communicating through video, especially.
That's a $1 million question, Manali. As a matter of fact, I have that on my agenda today.
So yes, great. So I'm really looking forward for your notes on that. Yes, thank you.
I'm glad you mentioned. Thank you, Manali. Yeah. Okay, I'm still waiting for one person, iPhone, to please unmute himself and tell us the reason why he's here. Should I assume he's not at his desk? Right, we won't wait any longer. I hope all of us have introduced ourselves and given our voices to this session. Mr. Anil Jain, you've done the same, right? You've shared your thought, right? Just so that we are all together. Okay, I request all of us to mute ourselves now. Doctor, do you want to just check who is this iPhone? Because somebody is typing in alphabets as well. We don't know who this is. We might want to remove this person.
Let me check by the time you continue.
Could you just remove this person, Doctor?
So there are 2-3 people who have not named themselves. May I request you to please name yourself, like 1+6.
Okay, this person has gone back to iPhone again. let's hope there won't be trouble. So without taking more of your time, I'd like to take you straight away to the presentation. And alongside, you'll have me, where you can see me as well. So I'd like to add, if you have a question or if you have a comment to make, I'd like you to come into the chat box and ask a question there, or at least make a note of it, so we can go through some of the questions that arise in our minds as a part of discussion. All right. So I'm sharing the screen now. Welcome everybody, and much to your expectations, I think all of us right now feel connected on the same idea that virtual etiquette, what is it? Do I need to know more? Do I know enough about it? Is there something I will gain from being here today? Will I gain something which is beyond my knowledge? I am conducting virtual sessions. I have a fair idea, but is that sufficient? And which is why all of us have connected on this platform for understanding about having a mutual connect on the very important topic, virtual etiquette, what is the reason? And therefore, I'd like to highlight to you that virtual etiquette at this presentation, we are going to focus on making ourselves a pro to create a stunning impact on the digital platform, okay? Virtual etiquette applies to various kinds. So it could be a meeting, it could be a team building activity online, it could be a session that we conduct online for students. It could be a training. It could be for colleagues, right? It could be a report submission. It could be a video conference. And we don't know what is the reason we might have to connect to our office and our counterparts. And we might have to establish connectivity in spite of all the odds that we are facing currently. And therefore, I bring to you the virtual etiquette understanding, all right? With this, I'd like to bring a few points of what could be your takeaways today. Ideally, we all need to know what is a virtual presentation and how to nail it. We need to understand that you have an audience, and every time your audience is different. So how will you understand and match to the expectation of your audience? Because that eventually will decide the success of your presentation. Beyond that, I think we need to understand that we have to be crisp and clear to make a very compelling impression, right? We want to create an impression that will bring about a change in people's thinking, right? That's what we do as trainers, whatever be the topic. So then we also need to present ourselves in such a way that people perceive us as a professional, although we are situated at home. Currently, I don't have an office, I don't have a desk, but I am at my home, at the comfort of my home. I'm conducting a meeting, right? So what do I do to make myself professional in my appearance? And there's some things about meeting etiquette that we all need to touch upon. And lastly, I would like to say managing the video conferences with you. Extremely important to know how to manage videos. Okay. Some of us need a product launch. Some of us need to explain something in an animated fashion. So what do we do then? Working remotely is not easy. It takes time. It takes a lot of connectivity. It needs a lot of pre-planning, okay? So it needs us to sit down, put our thoughts together, and understand our devices. Not all of us are device friendly. All of us need to familiarize ourselves with our devices. And sometimes the glitch can happen at the other person's end. Understanding your audience, connecting with them is extremely important. And as I say this, if any of you can't hear me or can't see me, or the video goes blur, kindly come into the chat box and just drop in a message. So we know that you are facing such a connectivity problem. And Dr. Swati and I will connect with you on the chat box to help you out, to connect back to us. In case it happens, it's just for you to know, right? So as you can see very clearly, it can become stressful if you're not organized, right? So let's go about and find out how we go. So what exactly are we looking for? We are looking for an understanding of a virtual presentation. Okay, I'd like to take you straight away to the points that establish the clarity for etiquette when it comes to a virtual presentation. The very first thing we all need to know is when you log in, kindly stay seated, stay present in your presentation. Very important, if whether you are a participant or you are the host. Okay, you make sure you bring your water bottle, you make sure you bring in your chargers. You might want to make sure you bring in a small snack just in case you got hungry. And keep it at hand. When you take the break during the presentation, you can snack on that. So if you got a 5 minute stretch time, you could utilize that time effectively rather than going and scrambling into boxes and cupboards and losing out time and coming back and logging in late. I suggest you plan yourself meticulously, okay? Let's just understand that when you stay present in the conversation, there's a great chance of you having a takeaway from it, because sometimes a presenter will give you a key point which you should not miss out. And that holds great importance with the relevant topics that come. And if you get distracted or if you, kind of walk away from your seat thinking, let me just go to the toilet, let me just go bring my bottle of water, you could miss out on some important content, right? So that is an extremely important point of how you should be prepared to be seated. The next point I'd like to bring to attention is the handling of our microphones. Usually our microphones are ready to go from the moment we start our presentation, be it as a participant or as a host. However, our microphones should be on mute. Okay? During the time you join in, you should walk into the meeting with your microphone on mute, because just in case 2-3 people have their microphones unmuted and it creates a noise in the room, it creates a very unprofessional atmosphere. Okay, so it is extremely, it leaves a very good impression of you if you know that I need to keep my microphone muted, unless you are speaking, yeah? And there is a way that if you want to speak, you'll have to connect with your people. I will come to that. So your microphone has to be handled with great care. At the same time, your microphone should be used in such a way that it should not carry the background noise of all your exhaustive pre-meeting conversations, and you know, it should not carry that forward into your meeting. So keep it muted until the time your audiences have walked in and settled in. If you feel the need to mute them all, then please put in a request that I will be muting you till the meeting begins in the chat window and then mute. Otherwise, it will be considered rude. The picture clearly defines that dressing appropriately is important. And very ironically, we don't have to dress ourselves fully. A lot of people take advantage, and this is like a magic happening where people can wear just a shirt, a tie, and underneath they could just be wearing their boxers or they could be wearing their pajamas and there's no trouble, because they don't plan to stand up and talk to anybody or walk into a room. And it's a matter of convenience, right? So your dress should bring you into a state of mind of work. What happens when you dress appropriately? You start feeling productive. You start feeling in the frame of mind where I am committed to my work now, rather than wearing just a t-shirt and walking into a meeting with frizzed hair and saying, oh, it's just two guys, no, just two of you, so let's just get this meeting over with. You know, I have to go into a shower next. I think that would become, that would be undermining the value of your meeting. If you have value for your work, if you have value for your time, if you have value for people's thoughts, I think you should pay a little attention to dressing well. There is more about dressing appropriately. I will be coming to that a little later. At least what you could do is put on a clean shirt and look presentable. So when people look at you, you shouldn't be a sight for sore eyes. Just that much would be great. I'll take you to the next slide, which shows us a few more highlights. Okay, there are a few more things. Okay, so when you walk into a meeting room, let's say you have walked in a few minutes late, or you are in time, and you have walked in 2 minutes late. This is usually for that. You should announce yourself. Don't just sneak into the meeting. Come into the chat box and say hi all. Let everyone know you have walked in. If there is a presenter and there is a conversation going on or a discussion going on, or the host has started the meeting, kindly just come into the chat window and say hi all. Do not unmute your mic and say hi to everybody. That would be disturbance. But walking sneakily into the meeting, not making yourself shown, is a rude act. So please come in. At the end of the day, no matter how virtual our lives become during this course, what happens at the end of the day is that all of us need to go home with a good feeling. Okay? Sure, I can do that for you. that better? Yeah, to create a great impression, Atul Sharma. I will come to the chat boxes and answer everyone's questions in due time. Announcing yourself, like I was saying, is a skill where people understand you have, there's a lot in that one thing that you do. You come in and you say hi. It speaks of good manners. It speaks of concern. It speaks of honesty because you have presented yourself. It speaks of value systems that you abide by, and it speaks of trustworthiness, right? So when you announce yourself, you've shown yourself, you have nothing to hide. So people believe in you, they connect with you better, they build a social connection with you, although you are still virtual in that space, right? The next thing I'd like to show you is how it is important to not keep going to your keyboards. Please don't do that. The reason being, the sounds of the keyboard keep playing in the background, and it is audible to people, and it can be a great distraction. So save that. It could be a sly message you're checking, or you think you're checking an important mail. And while I'm listening, my ears are engaged, but let my hands help me out here. So let me just quickly send a message. I suggest don't. I think give yourself your full self the presentation. Okay. The other point that we all need to... I'm just going to make a few... give me 1 minute, please. Okay, like I would like to highlight, somebody has scribbled on my screen, isn't it? Is everyone able to see that? This usually happens, I'm glad, and thank you to whoever did it. Okay. There's something called as disabling participant annotation. There is something called as showing the annotator. I won't say the name of the annotator, but thank you. This brings into perspective that you have to be a professional and handle it with ease. If you are taking a batch of students from the MBA or from the BHM or from the BBA, they are not going to be very well behaved right at the outset. You need to show them you are the authority. You control the scene. And therefore, if you are on the virtual platform, you'll have to know the skills of managing this entire classroom virtually. Therefore, you have to go into the caption, which shows you, like I'm on a Zoom call, I can show it to you. You can see my screen. Please go to more. You have a panel of, you have a drop-down menu here. Allow participants to annotate. Disable participants from annotation. Hide names of annotators. Show names of annotators. This is there in the third caption. Okay, so you can clearly, I'm going to clear. Okay, so I have cleared the drawing. As most of you would have seen, I have used my panel to clear the drawing. At the outset, what you should do when you have participants of a younger age group of student category, they will tend to play mischief. And for that, you will have to prepare yourself. You will have to mute them so that they don't start talking to each other. Okay, now that we are at that point, I will just tell you 2-3 points about it. When you are with a student group, they tend to play mischief. And on a virtual platform, we become helpless. So I suggest 2-3 things as soon as you open your meeting. Mute everyone. One. Secondly, disable or disallow them to mute themselves, which means without the host permission, they can't unmute themselves. Thirdly, go to the option of annotation, disable the annotation and disable and enable the annotator just in case somebody does it. Okay. Every time your meeting starts, you will have to do it. So be a professional. The point that I was making during that little scribble was, be a professional. It's very important that you have an atmosphere which is also suited to how you carry yourself. You cannot have a messy room or clothes hanging from the rack or doors open, closets open, and it's not possible to create the right impression if that's what you're doing. Okay? Having said that, we all need to know what do we need and what are the platforms available to us. Okay, very important is connection of the internet. Please establish a minimum speed of the internet. Please be aware. We need a okay. What are the kinds of speakers available to us? One is if you're using a laptop, you have a computer speaker. You could be using a microphone, and if you're using a telephone, you could be using a telephone speaker. you could be using the camera from your laptop, like I'm doing right now, or you could be using a webcam. So it could be a standalone, or it could be with your laptop. Okay, what can be your platform? We are very familiar with Zoom, no doubt about that. However, for security reasons and for familiarity, I think a lot of other web products are available, such as the Adobe Acrobat Connect, the GoToMeeting, which is very popular for meetings and conferences. And there is also MS Office Live Meeting, which is extremely secure. You can buy the account. They don't have any free connectivity, so you have to have secure login IDs and numbers and codes, and that's how they allow you to log in. So a lot of schools are relying on this right now. WebEx. And lastly, what we use, Zoom. Okay, so these are the available platforms. Where should be your focus? I think you should just remember that your audience listens, all right, but they need a break from time to time. So try to stick your focus on just one or two topics of importance so that you cover the topic well and give them a short break. Okay. You must give them a stretch break or a bio break so that it is very easy for people to stay driven towards your towards your presentation. If you fail to do that, people will leave their chair unannounced and seek comfort without your knowledge. Okay, so if you announce in the beginning that at the end of the session, this is going to be a 1 hour session, at the end of the session, we are going to have a 10 minute break. You can grab a coffee or you can take a bio break. Then people are more prepared and perceive you more professional. Okay, like the one I'm bringing to you right now. Okay, this is an example I have brought to you that you can allow people to take a break. Very important for people to take a short time for themselves. You could announce it like this, put your presentation on hold and come back to it. And while you do that, you should mute your mic, and if you are giving somebody an activity to do, then you must have the music on. But in a break, please just mute the mic. You don't need to have the music on. Okay. We all need to know what is required of a meeting, right? When you have a scheduled meeting, you have to focus on these four things. One, prepare a specific agenda that suits your audience. Know who your audience is going to be, who you have invited. Prepare an agenda well in time, so everybody knows and is aware of what is, and you share this agenda as well. Okay. Secondly, rather than counting only on words and your spoken language for understanding, I suggest you bring in a small format of visuals for people to connect with images, because there are kinds of learners, right? Some people engage just with words. Some people engage with a body movement. Some people engage with videos and visible content. So if you have visuals, there's a chance you're gathering the audience's attention, okay? The access URL that you're going to use, like how we have, should be shared well in time so that people can download the app if they don't have it. Suppose I had chosen GoToMeeting today instead of Zoom, then it is required for me to share with you that this is the GoToMeeting session and you get at least 24 hours to download and prepare yourself. So sharing all your URL and access logins is extremely important to be done well in time. No last minute. Please don't make anyone hassle. The last thing is KISS. We always believe in this, keeping it short, simple. Value people's time, right? And understand that everybody has many duties and they are here, they have made time for the meeting. So you don't abuse that, okay? So people trust you more next time. They know that you are specific to your time. And keeping it short and simple is the best. Presenting yourself in a conference and meetings. I think there are some important ideas for keepsake. How do you appear in a video conference? Very difficult to tell because you are not seeing yourself. You have to establish a random idea. So at the end of this, I'm going to share with you how to create your setup. But before that, some ideas that you could dwell upon and take to your heed is, when you work with solids, it works best for you. Try not to do stripes. Very you know, it creates a certain pattern and it does not show up very well in a conference or a meeting where people are constantly connecting with you. Sometimes a piece of jewelry that you're wearing can create reflecting surfaces, and these reflecting surfaces can be distraction. And also some amount of noisy jewelry, like maybe your trinkets and your bangles, and we do love jewelry, right? And so we use them. Very important aspect about this forum, this platform, is also movements. From the time I speak till the time you get the message, there is a time, a few seconds, that lag. It's not like a classroom session. So keeping your movements and your gestures in control is extremely important. Okay, you and like I said, do not broadcast all your presumptuous discussions. You know, so keep your microphones muted. Moving slowly in a presentation, as opposed to the content you would be able to cover in a classroom. Okay, although you're using a presentation format, even over there, virtual connect has to be slightly more slow. I don't mean in terms of slow movement of the body, like the previous time I just mentioned, movements of the body and gestures has to be slow, but the content has to flow a little more slowly because people need to connect with it and understand what you're explaining. And if they have a question, they might just write that down and ask you later. So when you ask people a question, the next point is that, how many of us take a minute and give them a minute to answer? Some of us could be facing a microphone problem. Some of us could not be speaking close enough into the microphone. Okay, so just know that when you speak, you ask a question. Please repeat your question for whatever it is worth, just so that people have heard you. And please pause, giving time to people to prepare to answer. So do not expect instant answers. And I also think when you ask a question, you should put it on a particular person to answer. That makes your space more controlled, rather than random people choosing to answer, unmuting themselves, and there will be dead air in the room and people will be in chaos because they don't know when it is their turn. And we could be speaking all at once, creating a confusion in the room, which is why I wanted to create that little discussion right at the outset, so that we experience that beforehand. I will move this annotation. I don't want you getting distracted. Encouraging your audience to put their questions out into a format, connecting with you offline to share the questions with you is a great idea, because people have questions, like how Monali pointed out clearly. I want to know specifically how to conduct a video. Right, how to do a video sharing. So that is a very specific question. So during my program building, I can incorporate that. Okay, so which is a very great concept. If you can share your agenda, even if it is not a meeting, and bring in people's participation to share what they are looking for in this program. The next. Some amount of do's and don'ts have to be followed, especially if you have participants, right? Now, you are the host. There are things you can do. You can prepare your screen. You can prepare yourself. You can dress yourself. You can create your background, all of that. What about your participants? Or what about if you are a participant and what should you do? In which case, there are a few things you have to keep in mind as a participant, that before you speak in a meeting or before you speak in a conference or you raise a question or want to bring about a discussion, kindly bring attention to yourself by way of putting it up in the chat box or by raising hand, which is a available option. Okay, please speak clearly when it is your turn. Very important to unmute yourself, speak your thoughts when it is your turn. It is very good if people respect the space and the opinion of all participants, although you might disagree. It is not necessary for everyone to agree. It's okay for people to have a different opinion from you, and you have to respect it. You cannot impose on others what you think is right, okay? Speaking clearly is very fundamental. Please be clear. Articulate your words. Very important to articulate. Moving and making gestures during your speaking up time as a participant, kindly avoid making too many gestures. It's not possible to understand what you're saying because the video kind of moves too much. Please be yourself. Don't hesitate to be yourself. And when someone is talking, do not interrupt. Okay? If you have doubts, please write that down. Listen, understand. Listen to understand, not to respond. Okay? This has to be a way of listening. To understand what is being spoken, not to respond to what's being spoken. And when you ask questions, try to keep your voice moderate. Try not to be loud. People can hear you. And if you think you're not audible enough, please test your mic before you start your presentation so that when you're joining, there are options where you can test your mic as a participant as well. And some of us were covering the microphone. I had to say, please move closer and then I could hear you. Okay, these are first-hand experiences which we got right at the beginning, where your microphone should be tested. You should know where it is and please be audible into that microphone. Because when you speak, you need to be audible. Okay? There is a very essential factor, what we call as human factor. Building relationships helps people to connect with you, work with you effectively. And in the long run, we need that social element. Although we are isolated in the room, we need to know somebody else is here who has a voice. So just being mute, listening mute, and leaving the meeting mute is not a great idea. Please connect with people. Say hi to each other. The host should take the initiative to unmute everyone. Give them a few minutes of saying a few words into the forum. So you are also testing your mic, you're testing your audibility, and you're getting a feel-good factor that you have connected with a human being from your work setup. Because at the end of the day, we all need a big social circle. Just having our families is not enough. Especially in this lockdown, that social connect is so fundamental. Very important to get the discussions in chat boxes. If you want to ask your audience for a response, kindly request them to bring a response into the chat boxes. And when you ask, like I said, I can't say this enough, please ask to a specific person. Open-ended questions can create confusion and dead air. There is a need to do a setup as per what is right, okay? You might have lights in the house in different areas. You might have your table put up against a certain area. You might have the windows working for you or against you. All the same, I cannot emphasize enough how important it is if you are having a video conference to bring the right amount of light on your face. Please sit with a window on your face. How do you do that? Please use your mobile phones to walk around the house if you have the liberty of using the entire house, or at least the room which you plan to use, and walk around the room and check where is the spot where you get the maximum light on your face and try to sit in that, plan your setup in that area. If not, use an artificial light just behind your laptop screen so that light falls on your face nevertheless. Right now, I'm sitting with a window to my left. So the light is coming in from this angle. And because this could create a shadow on my right side, I have also switched on the tube light above me in front of me. So if you are able to see me clearly, please say a yes in the chat window.
Yes, yes, I'm able to see you clearly.
Yeah? Yes?
See you clearly.
So, yes. So this is a little work. This is a little preparation. I suggest take that time and prepare. It's very important. Your audience perceives you, perceives your intellect by the way you carry yourself. Your intellect shows up in how you do things. Okay? So if you think you want your client to think of you as somebody beneficial, then show them that you are capable of seeing what is not visible clearly. So you have to establish that clarity for them. Please avoid harsh shadows. It shows up very badly on the face. Imagine if you have a light just above your head, it creates a lot of dark shadow on your face, which makes you look like a monster, not on. I think people need to feel at ease and therefore you have to do that for them. What should be the angle of your camera? Okay, some of us have the table chair arrangement and we put the laptop on our tables and we bring in our camera focus upwards. By doing that, you come to understand how many ripples you have under your chin. You come to understand how your nose is or your cheekbones are. It does not give you the best presentation. Right now, I have used an elevated platform on my table and I'm putting up the laptop on that elevated platform to be able to keep this on an eye level. Okay, this eye level establishes connectivity with your group. Okay, so also keeping your distance from this camera is so important. I could go further back, but my camera might not pick up my voice. Therefore, I choose to sit at this level. Okay, you should adjust your screen to make sure that your camera is able to see you and do not look everywhere. Yeah, so ideally, to make an eye contact with the people, try to look straight into the camera so people are able to connect with you. This especially happens in the webinars that we conduct. Like right now, I'm connecting with you and I'm making a face contact with you, right? So try to find the camera, look into it so that people are able to connect with you effectively, okay? You have to keep your keyboard at arm's length, reachable for you, and making the new meeting option and that is the option available on the Zoom where you just say new meeting when you're testing the laptop without any ongoing meeting. And you can just see the visible person that you are. Among the four options that you see on your Zoom, one among them is new meeting. If you just click on Zoom, on the Zoom app on new meeting, it opens up your video. So you are able to show yourself to your camera and judge how much light is coming on your face and your setup you can decide. Okay. And you need to let your family know we are working from a home. We are not able to assign offices within our homes. But if you can ask cooperation from your family and tell them that I will be on a call at such a time and I need you to help me with the connectivity. So don't go all berserk on your movies. Kindly give me 2 hours to finish my webinar effectively. And please request them not to walk in and out. Of course, if you have pets and they are walking into the room or a child walking in to get an occasional hug from you, that can't be helped. Okay? But try to have somebody in charge outside when you are away at your webinar. Just make sure that you have aligned all aspects, you know, outside your room so that you can conduct your webinar undisturbed. Right? Does anyone have any questions so far, if I may ask, before I take this any further? I'd like to take a short spell for a small discussion if anyone has. Any questions?
Deepak has a question.
Yes, Deepak.
Amina, is it a good practice to have a virtual background?
Could you repeat yourself? Is it a good practice to have a virtual?
Background.
I think it's deceptive. I think you're not showing yourself to your client especially. I would suggest don't use that practice. I have seen people create a virtual background. Their head looks like a bauble inside it. I don't know if you've been in one of those.
Okay.
Am I right, Deepak?
But you could have a decent wallpapers getting downloaded from the net and then use it. Right?
If you have no other choice and if you feel that this is my only option, then yes, but otherwise, if you can designate a small corner of your room or some place where you are able to put up your laptop and create, that personal feeling of I am in this room and this is my space, rather than creating a virtual background, it is a better idea to have that arrangement.
Yeah, see,
but
because when,
out of no choice, yes, we can go with a virtual background.
Yeah, because when we bought the places, I am sure most of us, this is not planned that we'll work virtually from home. So.
The impression is very different, Deepak sir. It's very different. I think it's always best to follow a simple outline. Like I said, a simple outline where you create a space and create an impression. I think that is nice.
Okay. I have one more question since we are on the call. What is the maximum time you think that the session should last?
So ideally, people recommend 30 minutes. I did mention in my slide of 45 minutes. A session ideally should give a break after 45 minutes because people tend to need a break.
Okay.
Okay. So what you could do what you could do is also bring in some interaction from people, bring in some sort of a polling, bring in some sort of a questionnaire, bring in some sort of discussions so that people feel connected to the webinar completely. They don't feel disconnected.
Yeah. So in terms of duration, maximum time, this session should be of how much time, according to you?
At one length, you mean 45 minutes?
No, total. You could have a couple of breaks if required, but
then full day sessions. I think I do 9 to 5 sessions.
Wow.
But we give even breaks because we give a snack, morning snack break. We give a lunch break and we give an evening snack break. And we wind up by 5:30.
Because my experience has been, if you do a full day classroom session, the energy taken is equivalent to 3 hours of energy on the webinar.
I think it's about when you have a full day session, how do you mix it with activities? How do you mix it with different activities that help you to emphasize your point differently, not just with words and spoken language. Like right now, you are completely dependent upon me. But imagine if I rolled out a poll and if I rolled out a questionnaire or something and you could participate in that manner. So it is a 1.5 hour session now here. So I know you'll hold up well. But for a full day session, people can't hold on to just spoken. So you will have to incorporate activities.
Question.
Thanks.
You're most welcome.
I've got a small question to ask you.
Yeah.
During the training session, what would be the period that you can give a break? Break in the sense, activities to be done at what interval?
The activities that need to be done could be based upon the topic you're trying to cover. For example, it could be a communication topic. It could be a leadership topic. Those topics will require you to conduct different activities. Right? Those activities you will have to frame well in time. That could be another discussion altogether because every activity should be engaging enough. It should bring about like a SWOT analysis, for example, like some assessment, right? Like some fill in the blanks, like a riddle, like something that brings about the inquisitiveness of a person, brings about the involvement of a person. Okay, that is extremely important.
Entertainment activities?
Pardon me?
Entertainment activities?
You'll have to say that again. I can't hear you. Could you?
The activities which can entertain them.
Entertain them? Yes, I think.
Get connected to the topic.
Yes, very much. I think entertainment is very, very, very needed in the virtual setup. In fact, even in the classroom setup, if you just split into a joke or if you just split into a small sense of humor, I think we always recommend that for a trainer to be a lighthearted person. So people look forward to coming to your sessions. Awesome. And if you don't carry a smile on your face, then people don't connect with you effectively. People need to feel at ease. I can see somebody is unmuted and I can hear you talking right now.
Okay, we have Parag who has raised his hand since long.
Parag, could you please speak?
Yeah, so I was just actually at the time when we were talking about the virtual background, and I kind of agree with Amina that those virtual backgrounds make head wobble. The reason a lot of times for that is because the virtual background actually requires either a plain blue background on which the virtual background actually works or a plain green background. So if we don't have that, then we get that feeling that somebody is actually not really.
Yeah, because there. The head shape itself starts wobbling.
Exactly.
That's a good input. Thank you so much. Was that Parag who just spoke?
Yes, this was Parag.
Thank you, Parag. That was a great input. Anyone else has any other inputs? Because yes, I think we are all out of experience.
We have Yogesh here who raised his hand. Yogesh,
yes, I can hear you. I can hear you. Yes, please go ahead.
Hello, madam. What will be ideal number of participants for a session of, say, about 30 minutes to 45 minutes?
What is your audience? Are you conducting a meeting? Are you conducting a conference? Are you conducting a classroom session?
No, a training session, you can say.
For a training session, ideally 20 in a classroom would be a right number. But sometimes it's not possible to have two sessions for the same group. You have to conduct the seminar. You have to conduct the class because you are completing a syllabus or a module. And therefore, I would limit that to 35, 40, not more than that. Thank you, Monali has raised her hand as well.
Hi, Amina. Great session, first of all, and thank you for answering the question that I had asked. I would like to add something here is, of course, the voice modulation is very important as an etiquette when you're conducting yourself virtually, your own voice modulation.
I'd agree with you, Monali. Very yeah. important to bring yourself to, tune yourself to suit your presentation. Any specific voice modulation are you referring to?
Yes, I mean to say, like, without sounding aggressive, one has to be very clear before communicating and not start communicating just out of, you know, too much of... the need is not there, actually. One should let the person who's conducting it as much as possible to get the platform first. And only on the basis of requirement, one should speak, I believe.
That's a good input too. I'm sure most of us would agree. Modulating your voice, I think, is a very important thing, because I think people connect with you and you speak clearly then when you focus that you want to modulate, right? Ravi yes. Kumar, sir, please unmute yourself. We lost him.
Ravi, you there?
I can't see him, ma'am.
Okay, maybe he'll come back.
Yes, doc. I would like to know your inputs to this. I mean, from our experience, like how Parag correctly pointed out that to the background, to the virtual background, you need to add another screen. That makes it easy to connect and then present you in the forefront. Any other inputs?
Yes, madam, this is Vasudev.
Yes,
actually, we had a beautiful session through, I think, Dr. Ayam, who had conducted right. the breakout rooms.
Right.
If you were in that session, I don't remember. But would like to understand how we can make up these breakout rooms and how can we, you know, go ahead into the Zoom. The Zoom has got its own special features, or it has to be, what do you call it, is connected to some...
Are you familiar with Zoom, or is it the first time, sir?
No, I'm familiar with Zoom, but okay. Breakout Zoom I haven't ever undergone yet.
Okay. What is Breakout Zoom? I wouldn't know.
It's Breakout Room. Yeah,
I'll explain you. See, I want to conduct activity in the group.
Right.
Okay, so suppose if 5 people, 7 people are in the group, I will make the room for them separately. That is one. So I will segregate the people into the respective groups. Then they will go along with the activity what we have performed, that we call it a group activity. When the group activity is completed, then they are all merged again as we are currently in the situation as of now.
Absolutely.
Then they will come up with their either the leader or all the willing interaction group-wise, so that we can conclude something positively.
Yes, I think this is a great concept. I was not aware of this.
No, we had undergone with that this trainers club itself.
I've clearly missed that training from Dr. Ayan. He is brilliant as well, and as much as I regret missing each and every session that I would love to attend here, but 2 to 3 is also a time for some other commitment, and not that I would think that this is less important. This is extremely important to me, but regretfully I miss it.
And I too.
It's at that time. So
secondly, that survey monkey questioning on the screen itself. I want to link this our presentation along with some questionnaire. It is in 3 words or something. You have to say yes, no, true, false, like that. That also how to link up this with the presentation. Is also essential, and this will, you know, it is tomorrow's trend or not today's trend, because tomorrow people are asking the question, that SurveyMonkey question should be ready with us, so that off the line, once our session is over, we are able to inculcate during the session as well and off the line as well.
There are 2 ways of doing it, Mr. Vasudev, Dr. Swati here. if you are using Zoom, there is an option of first is the polling. Even through polling, we do that. There are a few options as like saying yes and no that we have done in one of the sessions. I think Mr. Arun has done that. So that is also one way of, you know, taking the inputs from the participants. Room is something which will definitely help in doing various role plays or, you know, working on simulations, activities and all, which definitely helps. So polling can help in Zoom, where you are saying that there is, which Parag only have used in his session, that he has, worked on the another website, there he has created the question and which is linked to the session, what he was doing that day. So even that is one option of doing it. So there are nowadays, there are so many ways which is coming in and, you know, trainers are utilizing those things and making the sessions very interactive and, engaging for the participants. So like attending many sessions here, even I come to know so many things. So even I'm doing it daily, still, you know, there are so many things we are coming up. Our trainers are coming up with and it's a new learning every day, actually. Yeah, that's menti.com. We Parag has used. Yes,
Deepak. I mean, thank you. It is of a learning phase of as we are going with the VR etiquettes and all. Linking or increasing with the presentation and the questioning coming upside, and then we are having a yes.
Yes, Amina, you were saying something?
Yeah, Mr. Vasudev, I think we will have to collaborate our presentation skills into virtual etiquette. So this is the focus on virtual etiquette. But if you say to end it with a questionnaire, to end the presentation with a certain technique, that would lead us to discuss about presentation skills, which is another topic altogether. And of course, these topics are intertwined, but it is not a part of virtual etiquette. It is a part of presentation skills. So we will have to learn how to collaborate.
Interfacing system to system or app to app, whatever.
I agree with you, which is what I said. We will have to collaborate these concepts, you know, and sync them with each other. So as trainers, we are pros at that. So I mean,
this needs a thought process as such that how this can be clubbed up or interface and...
Okay.
Against the parties, whatever we require. Secondly, polling, as Dr. Swati mentioned, polling is also an awesome tool. It comes into the, probably you have 40 participants, 10%, 20%, 30%, like the people they give the polls. And that also comes into the screen. So, I mean, this is for me is a learning phase as such. I have to be
yes,
very
fair.
It was an awesome journey. Yeah. It was an awesome journey with those people. And whosoever gave us the, you know, guidelines or the advices onto that. But I'm going to ask the people.
I'm glad. I hope you enjoyed this session. Did it add any value for you?
I think he's facing some net issue.
Connected.
By the time, do we have anyone else who wants to speak to Amina?
Thank you, Dr. Swati.
Thank you so much, Mr. Vasudev. Anyone else is having any questions or anything we should discuss about the virtual etiquette? Please raise your hand.
There
were
some questions in the...
Well, Manohar here. I just want to give a quick one or two demos about the virtual background. Can I just do that?
Yeah, sure. Sure, Manohar.
I just want to... This is one that you can see. You can see how the face moves. Supposing you change it. There's something happening in the space. Something you want to put your logo at your back. Or you want to create anything. So the impression, it depends on the choice of thing. Plus, more importantly, as you said, the images. There's something that, see, this can also happen. You see there, like ghost image coming. It depends on how you prepare yourself for that.
Manohar, you mean that this echo sound, or are you sharing something on the screen?
No, nothing. I'm not sharing anything.
because there is your voice is echoing a lot. We are not able to hear it clearly.
Hello.
Yes, Manoha. Hello. Hello.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, Mr. Manohar.
Yeah.
Which mic are you using? Can you just go to your mic options and check?
Is it clear now?
Yeah, this is better, definitely.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, you're audible now.
Is there some clarity? Okay, maybe some technical hitch.
No, we can hear you, Manohar. We are audible to you? Hello? I think now he is not able to hear. Are we audible to you, Manohar? We can see your background. You want to show that to us? Yeah, I think he wanted to see his background. He wanted us to see the background.
Better that we go to someone else.
Yeah, so anyone is having any questions? Else we can
close. Yes, Swatiji. Can the speaker share the slide which showing many other options other than webinar and other things? So I wanted to look at them once again.
The slide you want? Which slide you want?
The slide which shows all other options apart from webinar. Like meeting and many other names are there.
Amina's slide you're saying?
Yes, Amina said.
Amina, which slide you have mentioned all this? Please, she wants to see that again.
I think she means the webinar sites where she can conduct the webinars. Like there are many, you know, go to meeting,
buy meeting. You are saying. Okay.
Yeah.
There is a long, long list, Ramya. If you want, I'll share in the group as well. You can check out the list. I have a whole message mentioning the list of the sites you can conduct the webinar. So I'll share that in the group for everyone.
Done. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Any Ravi, you raised your hand. Yeah, please ask the question.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, please. Amina, are you there? Hello? Now we lost Amina.
The speaker is last. Let her come. Let us see. Wait, no issues.
Hello, Amina? By the time, Ravi, whatever questions you have, you can ask. Maybe some of us will try and answer in between she will join.
Swatiji, Manoharji has come. I think if he can help us to understand what he's working on, it would be great. Yes, Ravi, sir. Sorry to interrupt you.
Yeah. No issues. So just my question was that, given the present condition when you are hosting a webinar, how do you set up your background?
How you set up your background? I think that's only the answer. And Manohar was trying to show us something. Can we ask you to unmute and give that reply? Mr. Manohar?
Hello. Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah. You were showing us something, some background or something. Then we lose you in between.
Earlier, no, about the virtual background. You can shift depending on the theme that you want to use. For instance, stay home, stay safe. It depends on the occasion and you can appropriately use it. But just make sure that the colors are pleasant, the choice of photographs that you make is good. And in fact, I was just trying to create for the trainers club itself a background because of the mic. Yeah.
That's awesome. We can see that your background is looking awesome, and it should not be distracting, I should say.
Exactly. It should distract primarily, you know. If there are sober pictures, for instance, something like this, it may not distract. If it is too colorful and all that, it is likely to, you know, it depends on what theme that you choose.
Correct.
You can use your business logos, like I'm using, for instance, our business school. You know, you could use your logos. Depends on what theme that you choose, ideally for the occasion.
That's been a very great
session. I must thank the resource person, Amina. It's great.
Thank you so much for your input and showing us this background, because this is actually for many of us, it's a help. Ravi sir, is it helping your, like, is it matching to your question?
Yes, of course, it is matching to the question. But my question was that at the given condition, at the current situation, where you don't have a work session at home and you are used to work from the office, at the given situation or the present situation, you are forced to work from home. So given this situation, either you will have to create an artificial background or whatever is there at your home, you have to set it right. Other than that, you cannot go for an attractive background. That's what I mean to say. How would you create
Absolutely. So mostly, let's say Amina is there. By the time I also say something, Amina, you can also unmute and reply. So mostly what I do is I try and keep a less distractive background, or maybe a blue color or a white color background, and also work on the dressing what I am doing. So that also plays a very important role. Like if you can see Mr. Chaudhary's background right now, which is more which is a wall, you know, but it's not distracting. So something in your house which has less distraction, or maybe a simple a curtain which will not distract. We can see Deepak's background also right now. Deepak, are you outside somewhere?
Yeah.
Home.
You're at home? It's a poster.
Sorry?
Is it a poster or it's
no, it's a virtual background.
Wow. So see the background, Ravi. We have so many examples right here.
Yeah. Then I would like to say ki the best way that you, within the given limits, what you can do is choose the best plain wall background, which would be not at all distracting.
Of course, better. We can see Mr. Ashok Goyal's background. Now, there is a light behind him. Is little distractive. If the light is in front of his face, will be much better, so that it will be a highlight on
more,
the face.
Yeah.
So, that way, we... Yeah. Correct, Mr. Goyal. Correct. You are listening to me. Now this, now we can see you clearly, and the back end light can be reduced, so that is a distraction. So this way we have to choose in our home, the place at our home, and these virtual backgrounds are of course a very good option if it is possible for any one of us. Any other questions we have? Amina, you are back.
I'm back here now.
Yeah. So there was a discussion on the backgrounds and the virtual backgrounds, and we got many live examples over here.
Yes, Doc. I noticed. Chaudhary sir, Deepak sir, and Manohar sir also have been using virtual backgrounds. And I love what Deepak sir is using. It's very, very nice, stylish and very nice. And even what Mr. Chaudhary is using.
It's a wall.
Very simple. Very simple and very neat, like as if you are really in a room.
Correct.
Right. But Chaudhary sir, is it your natural wall or it's a virtual background? Sorry,
I have to
unmute.
You have to unmute yourself.
No, wall is natural. It is not virtual.
Is it?
No, wall is natural. The design on the wall might be virtual.
Okay. I think he's still on mute. I can't hear him.
I think Manohar sir is trying to speak. You have to unmute yourself, sir.
He's showing the
It is virtual.
Oh, it's virtual? Wow, Chaudhry sir, it's virtual. Very nice.
Yes, it is.
Very nice.
It's virtual.
Mr. Manohar is in front of the Almira somewhere right now.
Yeah. This is the Almira.
Okay, that's some great examples you all are giving us. Thank you so much.
Swati, we can do one, filler after that 45 minutes as Amina suggested. Let's see the best virtual background.
Yes and no.
And do a small competition also.
Let's do it right now. We have four competitors, Mr. Chaudhry, Deepak, Ashok Goyal, and
You need to give us time so that we can prepare and we can download some more.
Let's do it right now only. We have competitors ready.
See, because exams are planned, it cannot be done.
Where do I stand otherwise?
I like yours background. Yeah. I like
decent. Even I like nice, Deepak decent. Yours also because it's very subtle and it's not distracting. So even your background I like with light, the clouds. Mr. Manohar is keep on changing and helping us that what all you can do.
Yeah, I just changed it because you wanted to have some diversity and people could experience that you can manage things likewise.
Mr. Manohar, do you have something else?
That's fine. I think it's very useful conversation that we had.
Do you have any other background?
Well, there are plenty of them. I can open the entire box. You can have your own realistic pictures to use it here. I could just download TC logo and put it at the back right away. Just takes 10 seconds going off the and then bringing it back.
That's so it's
really great. Yeah. Have to do it. For instance, I can just put my logo of my school, for instance. I can put my company name, or I can choose from general, you can go to Google and then see what background you want to just use it. Plenty of options that you can. Plus, you can make your own photographs. You can use you can use many things of similar, It's just that choosing the right thing.
How has a question that how you can make the virtual background.
How we are doing? Yeah. It depends on the gadget that you are using also. Sometimes it comes with, the app that is there with you. Some of the phones these days do have the options, or your tabs can have it, your laptops do have it. You can download from the pictures that you have on your camera. You can go for generic pictures that are available, or you can choose your own photographs that you have taken in your camera from your mobile. You can use pick any of those pictures also and then use it as the background.
Can you name some of the apps for the team here?
You can just go there for the background. There are plenty of them that are available. Sometimes it comes as, for the virtual background, you just Google it out and you will get. Sometimes the gadget itself will have it. Probably I can come back to you. I can share some links to the whole community.
Now Amina ma'am has come. Let us enjoy her wisdom actually.
Yeah, I'll share the links.
Thank you so much, Manohar sir. I think I've been here, sir. I've been listening to all your valuable inputs. And it's a very humbling feeling to be amongst the very great experienced trainers themselves. So thank you for the opportunity and I continue to learn from each and everyone here.
So,
are we ready to close the meeting? It's almost 3:25.
I think we are
Amina,
done.
Are you
yes,
done?
Yes, doc. Yes, doc. We're done.
Your presentation is going to be shared in the group or how?
Please do.
Okay.
Thank you, Amina.
I have a question for you. How are you changing it on the go?
I know it. If you press the button, I'll get a lot of options. All that I have to just go to the virtual background and then pick up a few.
While on the session, how do you change it?
Yeah, I can just bring up to on my screen, which you will not be able to see, but I can see it. I can choose. I've gone to the green. There are some pictures that some of them from my camera, I can just take it out. But again,
my question was, I have put some on the library, but how are you changing on the go? That's what I'm asking.
So it comes on the, you can take it on your screen.
How? That's what option are you using it to do?
Deepak sir, this is Paul here. This is Paul here. What you can do is, next to start video, right next to your start video or stop video, next to that there is an arrow, right?
Oh, choose virtual background. Okay, got it.
I've seen one in Odisha. He used to do fantastically.
Oh, Deepak has done that quickly.
Yeah.
Experimented.
Yeah.
All right. So I think it's lovely insights from every one of us. And Amina, thank you so much for coming up with the virtual etiquette, because oh my god, all the screen is here and there now. So
thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you so much for bringing this topic, because it gave us so much of thought process that what all we can do, and so many inputs which is coming in from everyone over here. Maybe we will do one more session on something like this, which is going to help every one of us. And it's going to help the trainers going forward for the many, many virtual sessions which will come in future. So thank you so much. We close here. Thank you, Amina. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Amina. Amina, your shadow and all, everything is looking very, very dangerous. Be careful.
Right now, there is. Okay. Yeah.
So this is not coming correctly for you, is it?
It's on your face, actually, so not on the virtual backgrounds,
and I thought I'll just check it out while I'm here on call with the experts. I'll figure it out on my own.
Is it possible to do it on the mobile also?
I think there are four options here.
Where will you find it? I'm not able to find it on my mobile.
Next to start video, there is an arrow. You can see choose virtual background option there. You click on the arrow.
Yeah, I clicked on the arrow. There is photo, document, web URL, bookmark, screen, whiteboard.
No. Which arrow you clicked? More or start video? The arrow next to the start video.
Yeah, arrow next to the start video is share.
No. Okay, maybe offline. Paul will help you.
There is a drop down menu.
There is a menu which is coming in.
You will not find any box.
Are you on phone or on laptop?
I'm on phone. I'm on my mobile.
So maybe that's why.
Okay, let me check it on my laptop when I do the next session.
Laptop is pretty easy. We just did it.
Yeah, laptop is much easier.
Yeah,
let me check it out. I'll call Deepak or Mohanty or Dr. Swati to check how it is done.
Yeah, I can help you, Ravi sir.
It would be great, no, to do a lot of learning should be there always.
And that's the purpose of this.
It is more of an experimenting, actually.
Ravi sir, your silence was very disturbing today.
You see, whenever there is a great, interesting topic, I keep myself silent so that there will be great learning if you are silent.
Your voice keeps everybody awake.
Thank you, Ravi. I take that as a compliment from you to me now. You liked my session.
Wherever there is a learning, I normally keep
100%,
quiet.
100%, sir. Thank you.
Manohar sir has gone into the R&D mode now, and he might probably write to Zoom directly saying how you need to do it now. A bug in the Zoom application.
Yeah.
Either way, we all are live on Facebook, and whatever discussions is happening, the people there are also watching all of us.
Just try something on my mobile too.
Oh, acha. So we have double role now of Mr. Manohar.
I had opened my pad and I'm trying the mobile as well. So you'll see two of my images there.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, we can.
I mean, this is a learning again. I'm trying to learn as I'm listening to all of you.
Deepak, it is great to have you in our group at least.
My pleasure, sir.
No, actually, so today's session.
Everyone. You want Mr. Ravi, Deepak. Every day they are.
No, actually. Rain, actually,
because he is a team person.
Yes.
we should thank Amina a lot for this because she chose a topic which has created a lot of interest in so many.
Dr. Swati has to take the credit for that. She suggested and she asked me if I can do that topic, and I said yes, and I got the opportunity.
But then so you have taken Swati, it.
Amina, there is one more thing for you.
Swati's bank account is still empty. A lot of credits can be deposited.
Yes, Deepak sir, you were saying something.
Amina, one more thing for you. You know, you completed in 45 minutes and you gave 45 minutes for everyone of us to speak and do a lot of research on Zoom.
Correct.
No,
for that, the credit goes to you.
Yeah.
I think we created that space.
You know, one thing great about you,
background.
What I've learned as a trainer,
background. Amina,
yes, sir.
You are very.
Pardon me? You have muted yourself, sir. You have muted yourself. Yes, now I can. Yes, Chaudhary, sir.
In fact, you are very, very popular class. For example, if somebody is hiding, you want him to be out of the class. iPhone. I could learn that. That needs a lot of...
CHACK.
Yes. See, I'll tell you, when you pick up the people in the beginning of the session, you understand that how many are serious and how many are not. And these people are the potential ones who will scribble later on your screen, especially when your group is a young group.
Can we know the name of our
iPhone? You actually,
we can
you,
still see the iPhone here.
Yeah.
If you can unmute and tell
the end that person has not logged out or participated.
What I feel is, you know, this can also be taken on a humorous part to attract the participants also, like what Amina did, no? Thanking the person one who scribbled on the screen and doing the things, right? We can take it humorously and make all others to get attracted towards it so that their attention is attracted towards the class.
Yes. That's true. I'm glad you noticed it.
We all noticed everything. Of course,
that's why I told I was totally silent till.
Yeah.
Military eyes can't skip.
Mr. Chaudhary, again, your voice is not at all audible.
No, Ravish sir, I'm asking. What is happening to your. Sir, what is happening to your setup today? Your voice is dwindling.
Well, actually, a lot of network issues here in Bangalore. So the voice is wobbling and even the screen is also wobbling because since yesterday they have opened the liquor shops.
That's a good
Amina must be knowing it very well.
Well, sir, obviously open because Maharashtra is closed out.
Yes.
That's why your screens are very
stable.
Yeah, stable.
Guys, Amina, I'm so sorry.
In Bangalore, it is the latest news. Sorry, dog.
Yeah, ladies.
Yeah, guys, we have another
ladies
session.
Ladies in the run.
Oh,
Ravi,
okay. Thank you.
Ravi,
yes,
sir.
Please.
I'm so sorry. I have to stop everyone. We have another session.
Amina, thank you very much once again for closing it much before time. So we got 45 minutes to chat with each other and some informal discussion also.
Correct. Thank you very much. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much, Manoj.
Thank you so much.
Chaudhary, Ravi, Arun, iPhone, Deepak, Viral, and Iqbal. Thank you so much.
You, sir, iPhone two times. Thanks.
I'm very curious, Doc. Can you reveal who is this iPhone before you close?
How do I reveal until they unmute themselves? I can't. All right. Thank you so much. We can connect again. Thank you all. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you very much.
We had a wonderful session.
Most welcome.
Thank you very much, Amina.
Thank you, sir.
I'm glad you.
Thank you, Amina.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Amina. It was very.
Thank you, Amina. Thank you, Bye,
bye, bye, bye, everyone.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.